So this particular IS-17 actually makes an accountant think like an accountant. It's more of an accountant's judgment. If you will see the word and the terms, the title of this accounting standard, which is 37, is quite difficult for a person who haven't been familiar to accounting terminology. So if you see provisions, contingent assets, contingent liabilities, all of these words itself are quite difficult to understand. And actually they are. And the reason for this is there are different definitions we have to understand, and so we need to learn how to record these items, which items will classify under these terms, and then how to record them and present them on the financial statements. The story of provisions and contingent liabilities are under the word liability. Liability is a present obligation which is resulting from a past event, and there will be future outflow of economic benefits. This is the definition we have studied in the framework of IASB. Further to this liabilities, there are two types of obligation a company may have. One is legal, other is constructive. A legal obligation may arise under the contracts, like a buyer or seller. We see what you have to sell, what you are obliged to deliver, maybe the prices, maybe you have to pay, under the contract some of the services you have to deliver, you are obliged to do that. But certain kind of liabilities are also constructive. You construct them, that means you are actually developing it. It is not legally binding on you to discharge them, but through your past informations, your past practices, your media releases, the way you tell people and create a valid expectation in the eyes of affected parties that you are definitely going to discharge it. To give you an example, environmental provisions. If there's an oil and gas exploration company which is using a rig to be placed in one place, and then they're exploring oil. And generally, when the exploration is done, then they will make a park for children to play. If that has been their past practice for already 25 years, wherever new places they are trying to extract the oil, people will expect them to make a new park there. And that's a constructive obligation. All of these will be liabilities if you are sure about the timing and the amount, that when we will actually pay it, how much we have to pay it. But if you are not sure how much timing or amount you have to actually deliver, we call it a provision. It's a liability of uncertain timing or amount. You are not sure when or how much you have to deliver. So we call the same thing as provision, and you call it a provision on the balance sheet. Detail of provision we'll discuss more. We also have to see what are the contingent liabilities. These liabilities are not there on the balance sheet. That means maybe we are not sure whether obligation exists today or not. And even if the obligation is today existed, then how much we have to pay, we cannot reasonably estimate it. When we have to pay, we cannot reasonably estimate it. Or the chances to actually pay are very low. So currently you may have an obligation in a court case, damages might be claimed over you, but you are not sure how much amount you need to pay or how much probability that actually you will be paying it. Or else there's a possibility it will be an obligation, but this will be dependent on the events which are not within the control of your own company. For example, if you have a court case that you might be having a dependency of this court case because your legal solicitor is there working, but if you have given a guarantee on behalf of some other person to a bank that if they will not pay, we will pay it. They will bankrupt, we'll pay it. Bankruptcy of the other person is not within your control. So events are when they are not under control, there are possible obligations. For possible obligations, you'll just disclose them in the notes of the accounts. I hope you guys are very pro in the financial statements analysis, and you guys know what the statement of financial position is, what is the statement of comprehensive income is. Thank you so much for listening.